Okay, you're gonna have to move. No, 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 no. Move. Go on. Go on. Go. Go, please. Okay, good girl. Okay. Hey, guys. Welcome to my craft beer review video. Way to go, Junebug. So it's kind of a crappy day here at the Rock. The Raspberry Rock. It's a little after 5, and, nice and quiet. There's no wind here or anything, but it's been overcast all day. It's kind of rained a tiny bit a couple of times. And anyway, got some electrical work done in the cabin, but now I'm doing a craft beer review video. What I'm thinking is I may go back through my other older videos and just see if there's any craft beer reviews that I haven't posted. I'm sure there are. And I know some of those old videos, the sound is a little quiet or off, and hopefully I fixed that, but anyway, let's get on with it. Oh, by the way, it was funny, one of my viewers said that he had a local craft beer that he thought I would really like, and I said, well, send it to me, but I kind of think he shouldn't. I think he was in Brazil. And it's kind of sad in a way, because there's tons of Ontario craft beers out there, and like I don't know, there's got to be hundreds of them, but there's got to be craft beers everywhere. Well, we don't see them in the local beer stores. I mean, there's imported craft beers, but they're only the can you move, please? But they're the special ones, the international favorites, and I don't even know what the term is for them, but you know, the big ones. We don't see like the indie craft beers, right? And indie craft beers, is that redundant? Is a craft beer from an indie company automatically? I think it is. Anyway, it doesn't matter. So, but what I thought is, oh, come on, Junebug, please. But what I thought is, if you want to send me a craft beer, like a local craft beer that you really like, by all means, send me a message on YouTube, or what you can also do is go into my channel, go to the About section, and then I think it's Business Inquiries, and it'll show you my email if you click on that button. So you can email me if you want to as well, and if you want to send me your local craft beer, by all means, go ahead and I'll review it, and because I think that'd be really cool. Junebug. She wants to be the star of the video. Come here, over here. Come here. Okay, lie down. Lie down. Lie down. All right, anyway, let's get into this. So I've got Railway City. Okay, Junebug, go lie down. Go lie down. Go lie down. Yeah, she knows what that means, and I don't like to use that. No, no, go lie down. Go lie down. I don't like to use that unless I really have to, because she will go lie down. Although sometimes she needs some encouraging. Junebug, go lie down. Lie down. Right there. That's a good girl. Lie down. There you go. Good girl. All right, so I got my Stella Artois glass. One of the few surviving Stella Artois glasses, because we've broken several already. A pack of 6. I think I got them from my buddy Ryan. So here we go. Oh, shit. Feel like something with a little more flavor than a lager, but not quite the punch of an India Pale Ale? Railway City Brewing put two craft favorites together to create Express India Session Lager. So Railway City Brewing Company Express. Got him. India Session Lager, 4.8% alcohol, IBU 18. DG 1.044, FG 1.008, SRM 5. I have no idea what those numbers mean. I tell people, I review craft beers poorly. Anyway, let's take a look at this. Yeah, there's a huge head on there. My wife and I used to go to this Wild Wings every Friday night, and we got to know the owners there pretty well. And one night, we went, and there was nobody there. We were the only ones there. And I said, "Can I pour my own beer?" And she said, sure. So I came around behind the counter and I'm always pouring beer like this, nice and carefully and slowly, because this reduces the huge head that I'm getting. So I tried to do that with the tap, and it was all foam. Nothing but foam came out. And she said, no, you gotta like crank it right down. You gotta be strong with it. And I thought, oh, that's different. So I learned how to pour from a tap. Y'all are probably going, you noob. You noob, don't you know how to pour from a tap? By the way, if there's anybody from Guinness out there, works with Guinness, I'd like a keg of Guinness and proper tap set. I'll review Guinness every night. That'd be awesome. All right, let's try this. The color is yeah, a good golden color, doesn't it? Can you see that with the? Yeah, not bad. So not like terribly hoppy. You don't get that huge citrus flavor. Well, that's not bad. I know they say it's not like an IPA, but a little more flavor than a lager, but not quite the punch of an India Pale Ale. Oh, yeah, that's pretty close, actually. Hold on. You gotta get these little ones that come at you. You gotta get them quick because they don't mess around. They just come in and bite. But that's not bad. I like that. It's got just that hint of the unfiltered taste to it. Anyway, there you go. So, Railway City Express India Session Lager, 4.8%. Yeah. Railway City Brewing Company. Wonder where that is. Obviously, it's in Ontario somewhere. Or did I? Oh, this might be one of the ones that I picked up. Oh, St. Thomas, Ontario. There you go. With a 519 area code, it's got to be down around, London, down that way. I would guess. RailwayCityBrewing.com. Okay, guys. So there you go. There's my first craft root beer review, and hopefully, I've got some other great ones lined up. I got a few craft beers inside. I don't want to do them all tonight, although I may change my mind after I've had a couple. But yeah, I hope this change of scenery is better. I looked at all my old, well, I didn't look at all of them, but all my old craft beer reviews are in the kitchen, or older than that, they were by the couch there. And I thought, now that it's summer and we've got these longer days, and when it's 5 o'clock somewhere, it's still light out here. So, enjoy the scenery while I drink beer. God, I've talked for 8 fucking minutes. I'm sorry.